and consequences that derive from it. The rule of law proportionally comes under examination in areas such as judicial review, habeas corpus, due process, access to justice and accountability of elected leaders to the electorate. Several challenges remain in an effort at establishing a firm rule of law system in Kosovo. This is particularly so in the fight against organized crime and corruption in Kosovo, but also in the region. Recent months have seen examples of challenges to the rule of law and with positive outcomes. One example is the recent controversial court decision regarding property in Vitina municipality. I note another healthy development, where the Constitutional Court is fulfilling its responsibilities in its decision that the Prizren municipality logo breached minority representation rights. And I look forward to action by the Prizren municipality authorities to bring the logo into conformity. It is encouraging for us to see the establishment of new judicial institutions, new entities that have recently handed down legally sound, well-reasoned opinions. In the fight against corruption and fraud, this judicial independence becomes even more of an imperative. As you ponder over the Kosovo that you wish to inherit from your parents' generation, be assured that it must be a Kosovo that has established effective rule of law in all areas of civic and political life, and that you can be proud of a truly democratic state of which you will be full citizens. One final point on the rule of law is to point out its inextricable link to security, both at home and abroad. As nations around the world grapple with new threats, be they man-made or induced by nature, it is with sound rule of law systems that they are able to keep their citizens safe and well, while engaging with international partners to address particular challenges. In Kosovo, the collective EU presidencies are working closely with the government to continue reform on rule of law matters in every sector. Ladies and gentlemen, while proper functioning institutions are essential to the rule of law, living within a society governed by the rule of law is as much as anything a habit of mind. And this is where each of you individually has a role to play. The rule of law is not only about big issues, like oversight of the government's actions by the Assembly. It is also about daily choices to respect traffic laws or to throw garbage in the right place. By respecting the law ourselves, we are able to make a legitimate claim on others in society to respect it as well. A sound economic system is yet another pillar which ushers growth in a state and ensures strong linkages across the region and the globe. The new High Representative of the European Union, Lady Ashton, stressed this point after a recent meeting with Prime Minister Feith, where she stressed the EU support for Kosovo, and I quote, through trade, through projects, through economic growth, end quote. She further added that Kosovo belongs to Europe. The region is a great priority for me. Kosovo has taken some rapid and important steps in the right direction, and it has acquired membership to the World Bank and the International Monetary Fund recently. Now, in order to kickstart growth, Kosovo should rapidly adopt far-sighted economic policies to stimulate sustainable growth and job creation, and to increase the inflow of foreign direct investments. It is high time to ensure that in a few years from now, Kosovo will have a healthy and dynamic private sector. Part of that is making the mental shift, seeking to control private enterprise, to seeking to regulate. The Kosovo authorities, ladies and gentlemen, have decided to open the three largest publicly owned enterprises to private investment and have already taken important steps in that direction. The privatization of the Postal and Telecommunication Company of Kosovo, PTK, of Kosovo's energy company, KEK, and of the Pristina International Airport will be among the largest transactions ever done in this country. The privatization process must be competitive, transparent, and well-designed. A successful privatization process will also send the signal that Kosovo can be an attractive destination for large-scale investment and is a reliable partner. As a small-based economy, Kosovo is heavily dependent on exports for its well-being. Kosovo's current export performance remains disappointingly low, and import coverage remains at about 12%. Therefore, regional cooperation is crucial for Kosovo's economic situation, as sustainable economic development is not possible without access to international markets and good neighborly relations. Also, through active participation, Kosovo can demonstrate its political maturity and attract goodwill, in particular with regards to Kosovo's European perspective. Staying outside of regional mechanisms would not only have important negative political repercussions, but also risk economic isolation. Ladies and gentlemen, faster sustainable economic development depends on the expansion of the private sector and the improvement of its productivity and competitiveness. There is an urgent need of improving the business environment, which is still inadequate, and stimulating private investment. The 2010 Doing Business Survey of the World Bank revealed disappointing developments. Out of a total of 10 business climate indicators, 9 have declined compared to the past year, and one has remained constant. In other words, Kosovo has only made limited progress in undertaking the necessary economic reforms according to this World Bank report. Yet, ladies and gentlemen, the external factors are bound to change with the ongoing transition to a functioning market economy in line with European criteria.